I'm Emma Sroda, and we're here at City Hall, where we've done a major remodel for some safety improvements and to encourage social distancing. We'll learn more about the project from our engineering director, Chris Hartzell. Hi, Marcia.
Hi.
I'm here to meet with Chris Hartzell, our city engineering director.
Great. Let me go ahead and give him a call for you.
Thank you.
Hi, Chris. Emma's here to see you.
Okay, great. I'll be right up.
He'll be out shortly.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Hey, Chris.
Hi, Emma.
I cannot believe how different City Hall looks.
It's really different, isn't it?
So residents who want to come in for services, they have to go up to the front desk now.
That's correct.
Why was this change made?
Really, it was for the safety and security of our staff, to encourage social distancing, and really to limit that direct contact between the city staff and resident.
What are some of the city services that residents can find now at the front desk?
Really, we can handle each and everything that we used to handle before. And now everything's going to be handled at this main level front counter, so building permits. If you just want to talk to city staff, you come into the main counter and we can take care of you.
So how are public meetings going to be handled now? If I want to come into a public meeting in person, how would I go about that?
Well, meetings are still with the city council in the second floor in the council chambers, where we're still enforcing social distancing measures. So you'll have to bring a face mask, but it would be just like you've always done before with city council meetings.
Was the front lobby the only change that was made in the building?
No, we made a few other minor changes. You want to come see?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go.
So we just walked into the offices. Wow, there's a lot of open space now.
It's really nice.
So why was the change made to allow for that?
Really, with reconfiguring the front desk and securing that front desk for the public and city staff, it afforded us an ability to be able to maximize the internal space efficiencies. We went ahead and reconfigured some of those office spaces purely to just see the efficiencies in the building.
Wow, and look at this room, all the natural light, and it's very wide open.
Yeah, you know, this used to be the hallway, if you remember the old city hall, where you would walk down and you'd be serviced by seven different counters, each individually servicing for whatever department. And now with, again, maximizing those efficiencies, we're able to reconfigure that into a much needed space here. So this used to be a hallway, is now a two-story conference room called the Evergreen Conference Room, as well as a number of other spaces we're able to capture those efficiencies.
Definitely more efficient, for sure. The overall renovation of City Hall, how has that benefited residents?
Really, it makes staff more efficient, but in addition, it's easier for the residents. Now it's a one-stop shop approach. You enter into City Hall and you can get all your services needed and taken care of right at the front desk.
That sounds a lot more efficient, really great, and I think that our customer service has been really great during the pandemic. Hopefully people are finding what they need and they can go to the front desk if there's something that they need to come into City Hall for.
It's been excellent. You know, with the pandemic, we've moved a lot of our services to online. So utility billing, permits, all of those type of things now can be serviced online. So you don't even need to come into City Hall to get exactly what you need for most things.
Except for your driver's license, that is still where you can renew it over at Washington County Services Center, which is next door, right?
Correct. That hasn't been here for more than 10 years.
Well, thank you, Chris, for your time and our tour. City Hall looks wonderful, looks great, and hopefully residents really enjoy it as well.
You're welcome.
Normal business hours of City Hall is 8 to 4:30 p.m. on weekdays. That's it for the show. Thanks for watching.